Hello guys, welcome back to another video from Behind the Glitter. Today I'll be showing you how to replace the front brake pads on Yamaha R15 version 2. So how do we know it's time to replace the brake pads? Well, it's really simple. All you have to do is to check the distance between these two backing plates. If it seems too close, that means it's time to replace the brake pads. And if you hesitate to replace the brake pads even after that, the backing plate starts to grind against the disc rotor and you will end up in a situation in which you also have to replace the brake disc along with the brake pads. And as I always say, brake disc can be carcinogenic. So please wear a proper gloves and mask before working on brake pads. So in order to remove the brake caliper, we need to remove these two bolts. And we will be using these 12mm rings for that. And after loosening the bolts, gently pull the assembly backwards and take it out. Now in order to remove the brake pad from the caliper, first remove the two lock clips and then pull out the guide pin from the caliper. And finally remove the brake pad from the caliper just like you see in this video. Here you can see that the brake pads are completely worn out and one adjusted metal plate just began to rub against the rotor. We are not supposed to keep the brake pads to this extent. Here I just got lucky without getting my rotor destroyed. And before installing the new set of brake pads, we have to clean the assembly. So first let us remove this caliper carrier which supports the whole assembly and allows the free movement of this floating type brake caliper. Now we need to push the pistons back inside the caliper, as these are the ones which forces the brake pads against the rotor while braking. And it eventually moves outside as the brake pads wear out. So we need to push it back inside to get adequate space while installing new ones. For most of the cases on a motorcycle, the pistons will move inside with a press of your hand. But unlike that, here it feels very tight. I guess it's probably because of the dirt and dust deposition on the piston walls. So let us first clean and lube it by spraying some diesel and push the piston inside afterwards. So now it's kind of cleaned and the pistons are pushed inside the caliper. So next we have to put back the carrier. But before that, we need to apply some grease inside the boots and on the sliding pins of the carrier so that the braking will be smooth. Or otherwise it could lead to uneven brake pad wear, hard or tight brake levers or inefficient braking. And now it's time to install the brake pads. And here I prefer using these genuine Yamaha brake pads which I have bought for ₹779 from a nearby Yamaha dealer. And here is a quick comparison with the older pads. Now to install the brake pads, first match the grooves on the carrier to the top end of the smaller brake pad and insert it inside the slot. And after that insert the bigger one on top of it just like you've seen in this video. And after that, align the bottom ends of the brake pad and insert the guide pin through the holes. And finally, just like we removed, insert the clips back in its place to lock the guide pin. As you can clearly see, there is a small slit between two brake pads. So align it in parallel to the disc rotor and slide it inside till the holes for the carrier bolts are in their position. Finally, add some thread lock onto the carrier bolts and then tighten it to a torque value of 35 Nm. And before taking it out for a ride, just pump the brake lever a few times to get the pistons back to its braking position. So with that being said, this is Gogulraj signing off. Thank you all for watching. Please subscribe to my channel for watching more videos like this. So see you with another one soon. Till then, bye bye.